On this next lesson for grade 9 and 10 mathematics, we'll be looking at exponents and square roots. Okay, so exponents, sometimes known as indices of power. So it's a convenient way of writing repeated multiplication of maybe a same number. So when you are multiplying the same number 3 or 4 times, it's much better to write it using the indices or exponents form. Okay, for example, if we have 3 times 3, we are multiplying 3 2 times. So this 2 times becomes your power, and this 3 becomes your base. So you will have 3 to the power of 2 is also equivalent to 3 times 3. So that's simply what's known as exponents or indices, sometimes known as power. If we are multiplying 6 3 times, then 1, 2, 3 is our power, the base of 6, power of 3. If we are multiplying 10, 1, 2, 3, 4 times, then it's 10 to the power of 4. Vice versa, if we have 11 to the power of 2, it's simply same as 11 times 11. 11 times itself 2 times. If we have 7 to the power of 5, then we have 7 times 7 times 7 times 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 9, 7. Okay, so this is how it works. So if you want to find the real answer for these powers there, then you will have to, if 3 to the power of 2 is equivalent to 3 times 3, then the answer is 9. Huh? If 6 raised to the power of 3, then 6 times 6 is 36. Times 6 again is 36. Carry 3, 18, it's around 216, so that would be your answer. But just to explain what is exponent, we are looking at this one. Now, before we go into square roots, it's very important that you understand what is known as square numbers. Square numbers, okay. Now, when we are dealing with square numbers, I'm talking about these numbers. When you're dealing with square, it's simply you are dealing with the power of 2. Power of 2. When you understand square numbers, then you will understand what is known as square roots. Okay, so if we have 1 squared, we know that we are multiplying 1 2 times. Our answer is 1 again. Okay, if we are multiplying 2 to the power of 2, then it's 2 times 2. We'll have 4. 3 times 3, 9. 4 times 4, 16. 10 times 10, 10 to the power of 2 is 100. 11 times 11, okay, we have 1 to 1. 12 times 12 equals, 12 times 12 is what? 12 times 12 is 144. And what about 13 times 13? 13 times 13, you should have 13 times 13, so 13 times 13. This one supposed to be 169. So all these numbers here, 1, 4, 9, 16, 100, 121, 144, and 169, these are known as square numbers. Okay, square numbers. When a number multiplied by itself 2 times, the result is a square number. Okay, so you must remember square numbers are the product of any number raised to the power of 2. Okay, so when you know your square numbers, it's now easier to know what is known as the square root. Okay, so when dealing with square root, okay, you have this symbol there. Okay, the root symbol there, it's same or equivalent to the power of half. Okay, power of half. So if we say square root of 4, it's simply same as x. A square root of x, it's simply same as x to the power of half. That square root symbol there is equivalent to the power of half, or 1 over 2. So if we say square root of 4 is simply same as 4 raised to the power of 1 over 2. Okay, so let's see there. I've written a statement there. Square root of a given number is the number which, when multiplied by itself, gives you the original number. That's why we have square numbers there. Okay, so when you get the square root of these square numbers, you will end up getting the original number again. For example, let's say x squared. X can be a number. So this x squared, if we get the square root of it, then we will have square root of x squared. Again, since we know that it's the same as x squared to the power of half, we can put it in a bracket, x squared to the power of half. There are two powers there, we can multiply straightforward, we will have 2. 1 times 2 is 2, 1 times 2 again there is 2. So you will have x to the power 2 on 2, so that's 1. Now what happens here is very interesting, because when you have your answer, after getting the square root of it, your answer can be positive and negative. Okay. So let's look at the example there. If we have 2 to the power of 2, and we get the square root of it, then we will have 2 to the power of 2, simply same as 2 times 2, so we'll have square root of 4. When we get the square root of 4, the answer is equivalent to positive or negative 2. So your answer can be positive 2 or negative 2. Why are we saying negative 2? Okay. We have covered earlier on that in multiplication of operations dealing with negative and positive numbers, if we have negative 2 to the power of 2, then it's negative 2 times negative 2, we will have negative times negative is positive, and 2 times 2 is 4. We can also have our answer as 4. And then again, we have positive 2 to the power of 2 is 2 times 2 is 4 again. So you have both 4 there. But if you are using calculator, if you are using a calculator, then if you get square root of 4, it will give you 2. Positive 2, but at the back of your mind you must know that it's also equivalent to negative 2, but most of the time you only take the positive value. Okay, so with that in mind, you can try a couple of activities there just to test your skills there. You have all this one, you can put 4 posts there, and then you try these activities first, and you come up with the right answer. Good luck, you can confirm it with your calculator, but first do it manually and then confirm it with your calculator. Thanks.